Hello everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Since this is the beginning of a new week, therefore it is our responsibility to do extra that we have with our new energies on this new day of this new week. So let's begin with our current affairs. But before that, the information for you all is that you can download the PDF of this session from the Telegram channel that we have in the description below. So the link of that Telegram channel is in description below. So from there, you can download it. Okay, so let's begin with our first question. Who has received the Indian Film Personality of the Year 2021 award? Okay, so this award was given at the 52nd International Film Festival of India. And I hope that majority of you who are aspirants who have been preparing for a long period of time now would know that this India Film Festival, International Film Festival of India, always takes place in Goa. Okay, now this year is the 52nd session, and in that session or in that edition of this festival, this award was announced. This year, this award has been given to Hema Malini along with Prasthun Joshi. So Hema Malini is an actress, we all know. Prasun Joshi is a lyricist. So both of them have been awarded with this award. Now, apart from their Bollywood careers, we also need to have a knowledge about their other careers in which they are penetrating, okay, or in which they are going into. So Hema Malini is a member of parliament from Mathura, UP. And Prasun Joshi is the chairperson of Central Board of Film Certification. So this clearly implies that both of them are holding very important positions. Therefore, they can become a question in your upcoming exam. So prepare this point also. Who has been appointed as the UN resident coordinator in India? So the right answer here is Shombi Sharp. Now, this person belongs to USA and he has been appointed by the United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres in India. And basically, he will lead the UN team in India. So he is basically the leader of the team that operates in India. And that team belongs to UN. And he will work towards India's COVID-19 response plan to recover better for the sustainable development goals. So this would be the responsibilities of this person. With which bank has PVR Cinemas partnered for launching the first of its kind co-branded movie debit card? So here, a new product in the financial sector, we have the movie debit cards. So all the movie watchers, the movie lovers, this is a gift for you all from the PVR Cinemas that they have released the debit card. Now, which bank is it with which they have partnered for this card? It is Kotak Mahindra Bank. So the name is Kotak PVR debit card. Okay, so this is it. This is the entire news all about that this card will be provided to the movie watchers or the people who want to avail the benefit of this debit card. And the benefit of this debit card is that you will get vouchers and extra points which you can redeem at any PVR cinema. Where is India's first security food museum located? So it is located in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu is the right answer. Now where in Tamil Nadu? Thanjavur is the right answer. Thanjavur is the right location where this India's first security food museum has been established. Which organization has established it? So it is Food Corporation of India. So it has been developed by FCI along with Vishveshwarya Industrial and Technological Museum, Bangalore. Vishveshwarya is an important figure in the Indian modern history. So M. Vishveshwarya is the civil engineer. Basically, he was the civil engineer, and on his birthday, we celebrate Engineers Day in India. Can you guys tell me when is his birthday? The date of his birth anniversary. Who is the author of Shuttler's Flick, Making Every Match Count book? So here, Priya Kumar, Pulela Gopichand, Dev Sinha, both A and B, both B and C are in the options, out of which option D, both A and B are the right answer. Basically, it is the right option, Priya Kumar and Pulela Gopichand. Both of them have written this book together. Which state will organize the Wings India 2022? So this is basically a civil aviation event. We will discuss about it in detail later on, but let's first have a look at the options. Telangana, Kerala, Karnataka, Punjab, Delhi. So guys, here the right answer is option A, Telangana. Hyderabad in Telangana is going to host this Wings India 2022. Now what is this? This is basically an event organized by Ministry of Civil Aviation, Airport Authority of India, FICCI, along with the Ministry of External Affairs and the state of Telangana. Okay, now the theme of this event is India at 75, New Horizon for Aviation Industry. Guys, theme is important, it can be asked, and do pay attention that whenever we are discussing about the Indian exhibitions or the conferences or events that are organized by the government of India, or let's say for any kind of state government, then also they are important. For example, you have DEF Expo, that is the Defense Expo. This is the Wings India. Okay, so similarly, we have Tech Neve event also that has recently taken place. I hope that you have covered it from the PIB video also. Now, my question from you is that the next year's DEF Expo is going to take place at which place? Okay, so tell me the exact venue of the DEF Expo 2022. Next point is important because the Ministry of Civil Aviation has claimed that India has become the third largest domestic aviation market in the world, and India has the third largest domestic air traffic after USA and China. Okay, so this is the position of India in terms of air transport or air traffic. So do remember this point. Now, this is also important because this is giving an update on the regional connectivity scheme, UDAN, which is full formed as Ude Desh Ka Nagrik. Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik, okay? So, 387 routes have been launched under this RCS UDAN scheme. Now, these 387 routes connects 62 airports, including 6 heliports, and 2 water aerodromes. So these are the total number of routes that have been opened under this RCS UDAN scheme that aims to increase the domestic air connectivity in India. Guys, can you tell me that when do we celebrate UDAN Day? This is also a very recent development and I have covered it in Spotlight magazine. So let me test you all, how rigorously are you preparing? Tell me, when do we celebrate UDAN Day? Very recent development here. Okay, moving on to the next question. Which company has announced its plan to build its own commercial space station, Orbital Reef? So we have SpaceX Orbital, Sierra Nevada Corporation, Borneo Suborbitals, Blue Origin. So these are the 5 options, out of which Blue Origins is the right answer. Now, who owns this Blue Origin? This basically is the space venture of Jeff Bezos, who is the Amazon founder and chief executive at present. So this private company has announced to establish its own space station that would be paramount to, that would be tantamount to the International Space Station that we have in equal size, in equal proportion. It is the plan of Jeff Bezos that we will create the life-size orbital reef space station. But let's see what will happen. But do remember that the company plans to do so by 2030 only. Okay? Kar bhi sakte hain. They are very ahead of us. So Blue Origin has been founded by Jeff Bezos. This I have already told you that this is the tenure that they have fixed, but by max 2030 they will launch their own space station, and this I have already told you that it would be as large as the International Space Station. 10 people capacity hogi is Orbital Reef ki. Okay, now this point is not very important. 10 people capacity, don't memorize it. Okay, But this is a very basic understanding. I hope that you don't have to put any effort in just keeping this in your mind. So guys, that was all for today. I hope that you have enjoyed the video, and if you have, then do not forget to subscribe our channel and hit the bell notification. Thank you so much guys for watching this video.